guys. Hello, hello. Gonna show you two clips. What I think, it's my personal opinion on the matter. From what I've seen over the hours I've played CSGO. What to do and what not to do in, when you're ecoing. First off, this clip is what I think you should do. Yeah. As you can see, we split. We go all on the same side. We don't have enough money to split up and die and not trade, because this is what happens. If you split up, you're gonna end up dying one by one, and no one can trade you because they're far away. So yeah, we split up, two guys on a main and three going towards Squeaky. Only one, but it's fine. He's alone in Squeaky. We can still kind of trade him, so it's fine. As you can see, like, the round has been going for 21 seconds, so I just ran in there and pushed. Like, there's no point in waiting, because if you wait, you get picked one by one. They can maybe trade you, but if they want to trade you, they need to pick a main, and there are probably like one or maybe three guys watching a main, so your chances are very low unless you have a deagle and you're somehow a deagle god and they know me from our one taps and shit like that. But most people aren't that good. So I just push and they don't inspect it. I saw that it wasn't smoke, but it was, but kind of shitty smoke. If they don't smoke early or they smoke shitty like this, you just run in there and shoot the guy. Pretty simple. They won't inspect it for sure. Like this guy, he got shit on so bad. And then if you do this. I did not tell my teammates I was doing this, so. But in best case scenario, you just tell your teammate that you're going to do that, and they're gonna trade you up, and maybe you're gonna end up in a 1v1 or maybe 1v2 or 2v2 or something. That will give you at least a bit of chance to win this round, because this round isn't supposed to be a win. It's an eco, so you buy stuff cheap so you don't lose much for next round. Pretty much the meaning of it. If I'm just telling you that you have nothing to lose, to just push and maybe get the round. Like this time I saw there was smoke right there, so I just all that way, hoping someone would push. No one pushed there, but it's fine. I get this guy, picked up an AK because I just push like a random dumbass. Sometimes it works. And this was a good strat. Like, we were three in quad. They did not expect this for sure. This guy is defusing, and it's dumb. But most people will assume there's only one in quad. So those are simple things, but sometimes it works. Like even in higher ranked games, when you're stuck defusing the bomb with little time, you just check what you just take a guess, and some spots are left unchecked. It's like this for every rank. It's common sense. And this is another little video showing you what happens when you just sit there and wait. This was about the same setup. One was B kind of lurking, I guess. We had one up. I think, yeah, I died. I was B with the guy, and I died. I was just scouting this one, hoping to just maybe peek and get a pick. Yeah, like this guy is speaking. If he's dying, he's dying alone. Green can't trade. So green is basically baiting at this point. As you see, like he's dying, guy's quickie died. No one can trade. It's better to just push together or push alone, and your teammate are gonna follow you for sure. Like, people are sheeps in this game when you don't talk. So, but sometimes they're scared, like this guy. This is baiting. For me, this is. You see your teammate peeking, trying to get a kill, you do the same. Like, it's, you have nothing to lose. Those kills you're gonna get at the end might be worth it. If you're maybe like, this is a 2v5, let's say it gets to a 1v5, he gets 2 picks, nice for him, but even if he gets 4, he doesn't have the round anyway. It's better to get four people with all your teammates alive, or at least one or two dying, not five, because this guy was just waiting. I'm just saying this to make people realize that if one of your teammates commit to, let's say, A site or B site, just go with it. If it's eco, you don't give a shit. You just go with it and hope for the best. Sometimes it works. If it's different, maybe if you have a smoke or like this guy. Another dumb thing. He has a nade, a flash, and a smoke. It's 117. Did not use them at all. He's low HP, he should use them and try to make something happen with it. This guy was like that. He's just baiting, another baiter. He did this whole game, that's why I'm saying this. Not too late. Anyway, that was pretty much it. Just push and hope for the best. sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. But most of the time you're gonna do some work. Like, it's a game about confidence, so. Thanks for watching, and hope you guys enjoy this, and subscribe, like, and everything.